Thank you. It's such an honor to be here today. So I want to tell you a little bit about this platform loop. You know, TerraCycle, the company I run, we've been operating in 21 countries around the world, trying to make things that are not recyclable, recyclable, from your dirty diapers to your chewing gum, and integrating waste back into products like ocean plastic into shampoo bottles and so on and so forth. And we always asked ourselves, is making things recyclable and making them from recycled materials the answer, the foundational answer to the waste crisis? And we realized that while it's critically important to do all those things, it's not going to solve waste, because it's only going to deal with waste at the symptom level, not at the root cause. And I'm really thrilled to say, just less than a month ago, this press conference happened at Davos at the World Economic Forum, where with the CEOs of Procter & Gamble, PepsiCo, even the head of Greenpeace, we announced this new platform called Loop. And I'll give you a little taste of how it resonated from there. Danny, can you play the first video?
Okay, ready to say goodbye to disposable containers. Recycling company
TerraCycle announcing a zero waste
delivery service
called Loop.
It's called Loop.
It follows what is called the milkman model.
Imagine the milkman meets everything.
For everything from orange juice to deodorant,
laundry detergent,
ice cream or shampoo are delivered
in durable and reusable packages
inside a reusable shipping tote.
When you are done with them,
without any cleaning, instead of putting it into a rubbish bin or a recycling bin, you put it into a reuse bin.
Une fois les produits consommés, le client replace les contenants utilisés dans le même sac.
And after you're finished with the products,
those containers are picked up,
cleaned and refilled for another customer.
It allows for unbelievable design innovation.
We have designed the package itself with stainless steel.
That particular ice cream container keeps your ice cream frozen.
Unilever's design team is working on their own redesign.
Major brands including Nestle, Procter & Gamble, and PepsiCo.
Tropicana, Tide, Haagen-Dazs,
Procter & Gamble, Unilever, and 23 other companies.
We've got a test that'll be going initially in New York and Paris.
Launch in May in Paris, and then New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania.
We're not only rethinking recycling, we're rethinking how we use every single product. The e-commerce site says its model is
nearly 75% better for the environment.
It moves from being disposable to reusable.
And my dream is that my kids or their kids can wake up in a world where the idea of waste simply doesn't exist. And we look at this time in history as what an anomaly that was, and thank God we're not in it anymore.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So the journey of Loop really began with this question of, okay, if recycling and making from recycled materials is critically important now, but not going to solve waste at the root cause, how do we do so? And also, where did waste come from? Because back, you know, 100 years ago when these models existed, the milkman model, there wasn't the modern idea of waste. And what was really interesting about these models, sort of an unintuitive thing, is who owned the packages in these models? Because in many cases, it was the manufacturer. When the manufacturer owns a package, they want to make it long-lasting and durable, not for the environment, just for their own financial wherewithal. And then in the 1950s, this happened. And by the way, this is an actual photo advertising disposability. Today, it's sort of like looking at a cigarette ad from, you know, 50 years ago, where your doctor recommends, you know, your Camel cigarettes. It's a little odd today, but the key thing, there's two weird things happening here. One is, who owns the package now? It shifts from the manufacturer to the consumer. And you know, we today buy disposable products all the time, every day. How many people here cherish the packages they buy? I mean, you own them. Do any of you actually want to own it? So that's really weird. Not one person here wants to own 99% of the things you buy. The other sort of strange thing is when the package becomes property of the consumer, it becomes a cost of goods sold to the manufacturer. But it's also important not just to vilify disposability. It's very important to look at what are its virtues. And the virtues that are celebrated in this actual advertisement are affordability and convenience. And I'd say those are so big that people will still vote for disposability, knowing full well the consequences of waste. But when packaging becomes a cog, and the goal of manufacturers then is to reduce that cost, this happens. You know, Pepsi's one of the founding partners of Loop, and we mapped out their packaging from when they began in refillable bottles to where they're trending today, which is thinner, multi-layered laminates. Now, two very positive things happen in this trend. One is that the packaging becomes significantly cheaper, which democratizes the product. Second, it's also way less material use, which is way more sustainable from a creation point of view. But there's two unintended negatives. The blue line shows you the actual rate of reuse or recycling for these packaging forms in the US today, and it crashes down to zero where you get to the laminate. And the reason it does is not because they're not technically recyclable, it's because it's less profitable for waste management companies to collect and process these things, because recycling is simply urban mining. The other negative, though, is when you ask consumers which of these pack forms would they want their packaging, their beverage in the most, and which the least, they say it's an order from the glass bottle all the way to the pouch. So consumers lose in the process a little bit. Now, we looked at a lot of refill models, because Loop is not the first refill model at all. And you know, it's refill stations at supermarkets, it's buying bulk at club stores and filling into smaller packs or packaging-free supermarkets, all amazing ideas. But when we really dissected their models, we realized that there's one challenge, which is convenience. All of them ask for a slightly less convenient approach, and it's a big barrier to overall scale. So the thesis for Loop with all of our partners became, how do you solve for the unintended consequences of disposability while maintaining its virtues? And the critical unlocking, and by the way, the prices here are made up, this is just to give you a sense of scale, became shifting ownership, because we don't want to own this stuff anyway, so why own it? On the left, you see a normal deodorant container, relatively low cost, but only one use. Even if it gets recycled, it's only used once in that form. On the other side, you see the actual new Unilever Loop deodorant container, which I think is epically beautiful design, but it's never owned by the consumer, it's just borrowed. Now, to do that, you have to spend more money, but now it shows up as an asset that depreciates over the total number of uses, actually coming in line with the cost of disposability. And that unlocks the magic of what durability brings. This is now about a third of the brands involved in this platform. And durability brings three things. First, yes, it becomes reusable. That's the intuitive, easy to understand idea. But it also brings about unparalleled materials that can be designed in ways you can't do today. I mean, not even in the same ballpark, a whole new stratosphere of design. And those materials and those forms can even bring new features. Here are some examples of the new Häagen-Dazs container or the new Mondelez package for biscuits. I mean, this ice cream container not only is beautiful, feels great. It keeps your ice cream frozen for 3 hours on the go. Whether it's salad dressing now in reusable containers all the way to private label products from major retailers with Carrefour in France. And here's an interesting example. You see what in private label they did with oil. And here's what when a major oil company did the same thing on reusable oil, mayonnaise, containers they did. This is Le Sueur in France. Whether it's mayonnaise here with Hellmann's, all the way to beverage containers echoing a little bit of their history. This is the new Pepsi range with Tropicana developing a bottle in beautiful reusable glass. And by the way, that is the final labeling. So it's also very designed to be beautiful in your home. Whether it's bringing back some original examples, all the way to one of my favorite areas of innovation has been what's happened in the personal and oral care area. This one is just a really interesting example because the rules of Loop are you must have a durable container. But tubes cannot be durable today. They can't be cleaned and reused. So Unilever had to redesign away from a toothpaste tube into a beautiful glass jar. But then it's hard to put toothpaste into a glass jar, so they also redesigned the toothpaste itself to be dehydrated tablets, which means way less or no water, perfect dosage, and you can even travel with this, unlike a big tube of toothpaste. Whether it's, and this is the key in design, it's not just about reuse. It's about the future of design. You can see Pantene 2019 version, but also Pantene already released what 2020's bottle will look like, both in pure aluminum. I mean, unparalleled design. Whether it's other forms of shampoo, to mouthwash, to how your dish soap will come, to even how your deodorant will come. It pushes the design and the features. So it's all about the future of consumption. And in the future, the idea of waste simply doesn't exist. But the future is not about not having waste. The future is about experiencing products in a better, more functional way, like a wipes dispenser that keeps your wipes wet longer and is beautiful on shelf and. Oh, and by the way, the concept of waste simply doesn't exist. So we came up with a nomenclature of rules. The rules of Loop are effectively your package must be durable. Now your diapers come in actually a diaper genie. This is version one, the next one is even more beautifully designed. And then there's content. What do you do with the content? There's really three types. There's content you can't recover, like orange juice, so as long as it's legal, no problem. And then there's content that can be recovered, but maybe unreasonable to reuse, like a dirty diaper or a feminine hygiene product. There, it must be recovered and must be recycled. This will be the first time in France diapers, femcare, and wipes are now recyclable. That'll start in May. And if it can be reused and can be recovered, it must go to reuse. And I'm going to finish with showing you one of the most interesting designs, the new manual toothbrush through Loop. So if we can play the final video, please.
Hey, no, I love it when it goes my way, hey now, I love it when it goes my way.
So hopefully you agree that, you know, a future without the idea of waste can absolutely be real. Loop will be launching in May in Paris, as well as in the northeast of the United States, in September in London, and we hope you'll be a part of it. With that said, thank you.